Hey guys, so I'm back for another new foundation review. Today I'm going to be trying out the new Hourglass Vanish Seamless Finish Foundation Stick. That's a mouthful. And I'm also going to be using the new coordinating brush that goes with it. So I will be trying out shade Nude. It's really cute packaging wise. It's like a triangle stick that's twisty. Really, really cool. So let me give you guys some stats about it real quick. I have the little pamphlet. It comes in 26 different shades, and this is the range. That's a pretty good range. I am about right here, so directly in the middle. And the claims would be that it is double the amount of pigment versus traditional foundations. It has a full coverage finish, 12-hour long wear, waterproof formula, and it is supposed to adjust to the body temperature to blend into the skin for the smoothest, most seamless finish. So it says to prep with their primer, which I have right here, so I'll do half of my face with that, and then I'm gonna try it out with the brush as recommended, and then try it out with the sponge just to see how that goes. And it says that it's supposed to cover discoloration, pores, blemishes, dark circles. We'll see how this goes. It says use a circular motion and apply 2 to 3 dots to each section of the face. Start with less and add more. Let's do it. Right after putting this on my face, I realized, one, I might have put a little much. I'm gonna blend some of this out. And I should have put it on the other side of my face. Because this is the non-blemished side. Ew, well. All right. So, as far as price goes, the brush and the foundation both retail for $46 each, while the primer is a little bit more expensive depending on what size you get. Now, we'll just... Okay. Really scared that it's gonna work really, really fast. I don't know if that counts as dots, it's more like swipes. So, let's do this. Color's really, really nice. It blends really nice. So it really does just have a nice natural finish for sure. Now let's try out this side without primer. It's very, very creamy, which I like. It takes a little bit more pressure without the primer to buff it in. Like, I can feel more tension on the brush. It doesn't glide over like as smooth of a base, because the primer gives you like kind of like a perfect silicone-y feel. I don't know how else to describe it, but like a really nice slippery feel. I'm gonna add a little bit more for more. Okay, that was a lot of it more. For more cover. I mean, this side looked pretty good. And I'm gonna try to blend it out with a sponge. Still looks good with a sponge. It's definitely full coverage. Like, wow. Go over with the brush. The brush is just like a dense, almost angled. Let's take some pictures. I'm not fully sure why it's giving me like a very, very slight white cast as far as flash photography goes, because it doesn't seem to have any SPF. Another thing to note, because I forgot to mention, this brush is PETA approved, if you guys are interested in that. I feel like my forehead looks so funny. But anyway, I think I'm just gonna finish up my makeup, put a little under eye concealer on, finish the rest of my face, and take another picture for you guys. I'll see you guys at the end of the day. Man, this finish. It's very accurate. It's very, very flawless. I kinda like that. All right, see you guys in a little bit. Hey guys, so it's the end of the day now and it's been about 7 hours. Let's see how it held up. I took pictures already. Now let's get all up close and personal. So as far as the prime side goes, it looks way better than the unprime side. If you have dry skin, I don't know how this is gonna do for you, because I have one dry patch right here and it is the most unflattering spot in my entire face. Like, it's noticeable to me. So if you have severely dry skin, you either are gonna have to moisturize a lot or use a heavy, heavy primer that moisturizes. Or maybe this would be better for those who have normal to combination skin. As far as my oiliness goes, I'm oily in my usual areas. My nose is doing what it usually does, so is the center of my forehead. So my T-zone and the sides of my nose I mean, the size of my nose aren't too bad, so it's mainly my T-zone. This is highlight, so don't worry about this too much, guys. But this is not, it's not that bad. It's nothing like crazy compared to how my foundation usually wears. I think with a mattifying primer, aside from just like a regular primer, something that's meant for oil control, this would still be a good foundation to use. My contour is still on, my cheeks are still good, so it means the foundation itself is holding up. The coverage is still at full. And aside from that, there are no other issues. There's like no pore issues, no fine line issues. I like it as far as how it held up, aside from the oily factors, which I tend to always have unless I use something to prevent those. So all in all, I think it's not bad. I like the shade match. So nude is definitely my shade. For those who are waiting to hear about my shade for this foundation, it's definitely nude. I think it's similar to the Hourglass Immaculate in a sense that when I cream contour with it, because the finish is kind of closer to matte, it's like a demi matte to almost fully matte, it's a little harder to cream contour. I still cream contoured anyway with this one because it's not like super powder finish. So just keep that in mind if you are a fan of doing that over your foundation. I'd cream contour over this over the Immaculate any day though, because the Immaculate is way more powder finish. I think you can get away without wearing a powder, but I put a little bit of a translucent powder by Kat Von D on as far as like all that goes because I was cream contouring. Otherwise, if you set yourself really well, use some oil controlling things and maybe blot, you could make it work for oily skin. So normal combination oily, I think you get a thumbs up for this. Dry skin, I would say stay away unless you have some preventative like primer that you really, really love. So I hope you guys enjoyed hearing my thoughts on the new Hourglass. What are you called? Vanishing or Vanish Stick Foundation. If you guys enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in a later video. P.S. I will be reviewing this soon. Everyone's tweeting me pictures and Instagramming me. I'm gonna review the new Estee Lauder foundation soon. Got it.